Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video on light wrap in action, you learned how to apply a light wrap to an image surface in the 3D scene. This is quite a common technique, which allows you to better integrate your keyed images with their backgrounds. Now, since the light wrap functionality is considered as a component of the 3D compositor, it's also possible to apply a light wrap to 3D geometry. This could be used for integrating the 3D component in the composite, or adding extra color and lighting to your 3D objects as part of a motion graphic. In this video, you'll experience light wrapping a 3D model. And you'll also combine this with other tools such as image-based lighting and physical texturing. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Import the downloaded footage into Flame and load the start batch setup into the batch group. Now, looking at the flow graph, you have a photo that's been resized, and that's being fed into the Action Compositor as the image background. If you go into Action with the 2-up view using Alt 2, a setup has already been provided with the camera, light, and some imported 3D geometry. Now, this could be any 3D model, and currently, all the geometry is textured using a material node. The material node could be generated as part of an import, or you could have added it at a later point. Either way, when you call up the material node's controls, you'll be able to access the light wrap menu. Currently, the 3D model is unaffected by the light and colors of the background. So zoom into the viewport and activate the controls. With the default settings, you should see a very subtle effect. The overall amount is fine, but increase the layer 1 effect to 1.5 and up the gain to 2.0. To remove some of the darker areas affected by the light wrap, increase the tolerance to 25%. If you're not sure what each control is doing, please see the first video on light wrap in action where all the controls were explained in detail. Now let's add another layer to push the light wrap further. Activate layer 2 and push the gain to 2.0. When you toggle the light wrap on and off, you can see how the lights and the colors from the background image wrap around the 3D model. Frame the composite to the viewport. Now, if you rotate the 3D model in the 3D scene, you should note how the light wrap changes depending on the object's position within the 3D scene. So, like an image surface, the light wrap takes into account the 3D composite. If something else was behind this 3D model, the light wrap will adapt accordingly without the need to output separate mats and build large node flow graphs. Now let's make this more interesting using further lighting and texturing on the 3D model. Select the light in the action schematic and press H to hide the light. To use image-based lighting or IBL, select the camera and add an IBL node through the contextual menu. This currently uses the background to light the model, but let's use a different lighting map. Switch to the Read File menu and load the empty lab EXR through the file browser. This gives the 3D object a more neutral lighting. You can also go to the Controls menu and adjust the rotation of the mapping to change the angle of the lighting. Set the X rotation to 3. Next, in terms of texturing, you can use any kind of texture even while light wrap is being applied. Select the material node and using the contextual menu, choose to add a substance PBR texture. This launches the browser with all the physical based textures. Navigate to the metal directory and choose metal, aluminium or aluminum brushed. The PBR texture is applied to the geometry, and you can edit its properties. Select the Substance node, and in its Advanced menu, turn on Dirt, Scratches, and Oxidation. Now you can play around with the texture and lighting as much as you like. But during this entire time, the light wrap is still applied and is wrapping the light and colors of the background around the 3D model. If you go back to the light wrap controls in the Material node and toggle the light wrap on and off, you can see how the light wrap is adding to the geometry and better integrating it into the final composite. So light wrap is very useful for integrating keyed images in your everyday composites. But it's always worth remembering that you can use light wrap creatively when using either 2D or 3D objects. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.